We all know that 2FA secures your online accounts. However, the idea of retyping a token each time you log in may be a little bit frustrating, especially when you hit the 29-second mark and you have to wait for the next token and you do not know what the next token is. But there is a way to speed it up. Let me show you. Ready? Separation in 3, 2, 1. Okay, here I will show you how quickly can you log into your Twitter account using 2FAS app. And here I will show you how quickly can you do that using our browser extension. Okay, so let's start. Let's put our login and password and go. Now let's retype the code. Let's turn on 2FAS app. Okay, let's log in. 028836. Next. Done. Okay, that was really nice. Now let's use browser extension. So let's log out from this account and let's log in again. Our login, our password, and now ready, set, go. Let's click on the browser extension icon. Approve and code sent successfully. That's it. Done. It was fast, wasn't it? That was fast. I know. I know. Hi guys, I'm Andrew from 2FAS and today we will talk about 2FAS browser extension. I will show you how to install our browser extension, how to set it up and how to use it. First, we have to go to our website, 2fas.com/browser-extension. Okay, when we are here, we have to click the button Install Extension. So let's do that. And now you will be redirected to your browser's web store. In my case, it's Chrome Web Store. Now you can see this is our browser extension and we need to click the button Add to Chrome. Now you will see a monitor, 2FAS app want to read and change all data on all websites. This is crucial for our browser extension to work, just to know where to automatically put your 2FA token. So let's click Add Extension. And that's it. Your browser extension is installed. Now let's follow the instruction on the screen. To start, you need to pair this extension with the 2FAS mobile application. You need to do this so that when you will use 2FAS browser extension, the browser will know which phone to ask for your token. So let's open our app and let's click I've installed the app. Now you will see a QR code which we need to scan with 2FAS application. So let's go to settings and browser extension. And because we've already installed browser extension, let's tap the button pair with the web browser. And that's it. Your phone is paired with your browser extension. Now, this is important to allow 2FAS app to receive push notifications from browser extension. So let's tap continue and allow. And as you can see, we've paired our device with Chrome on Windows. And now on your screen, you will see the information that 2FAS browser extension is successfully paired with your 2FAS app. And you will see a play video button. If you click this video, there will be an inception moment because you will see this exact video. After watching this video, you will know what to do next. So, next, let's click Go to Settings. And here you will see 2FAS browser extension settings. Now, first clue is to pin 2FAS browser extension to your top bar. To do that, let's follow the instruction here on the upper right corner. Got it? So we have to click the puzzle button and click the pin icon next to 2FAS two-factor authentication. Let's do that, and as you can see, the icon of 2FAS browser extension showed up on the top bar and it's ready to be used. Now here you can see that our browser nickname is Chrome on Windows, the same as you saw on the mobile app, and below you will see paired devices. In our case, it's Google Pixel 7 Pro. Now below you can add another device. You can set up or just use a shortcut to use a 2FAS browser extension. And below there are advanced settings. Let's click that. Now by default, 2FAS browser extension will send you notification on your computer natively. But if you want to or you've disabled notification in your web browser, you can switch to 2FAS custom notifications. Then they will be shown in the upper right corner. But I will use a native browser notification. We can test it. So native looks like that at the bottom right corner, and custom notifications look like that at the upper right corner. I will leave native browser notification. Now, sometimes when things may go wrong and will ask you to send us logs, you can do that by clicking the approve 2FS browser extension logs. I will not do that right now because everything is working fine. So let's turn off advanced options. And on the left, what you can see, you can go back to rewatch this video. We are on the settings tab. You can read more about 2FAS app. You can donate to 2FAS, or you can go to 2FAS support page. Okay, now it's time to show you how it works in real time. Let's close this and this tab, and let's go to, let's say, Twitter. Okay, here when we click on sign in, we have to, of course, put our login. We have to put our password. And now we will be asked to enter the 2FA code. So what to do? Simply click on the 2FAS browser extension button, and the browser extension will send a push notification on our phone, as you can see here. Do you want to share the 2FA token with twitter.com? We of course say approve. Yes, we want. When we open 2FAS app or tap on the push, we will be asked to select a token which should be sent back to the browser. I will tap on Twitter, of course, and the code is sent successfully. Okay, now let's click next, and we are in. Now, this is very important. You will be asked to select the token only first time for each service. The next time, the token will be sent automatically, as I will show you in the second. Now, why you should select the token for the first time? Let me explain. When you add a token to your 2FAS app, you can name it whatever you like. And when browser is asking for a token for example, twitter.com domain, the 2FAS app on your phone doesn't know which token is for this domain. And so the app will ask you for the first time, twitter.com, which token is it? You will select it and it will be saved. And next time your browser will ask your phone for a token for twitter.com, it will be automatically sent because now 2FAS app on your phone knows which token to send. And to show you that it works like that, let's jump into the Twitter. Let's log out from our account. And one more time, let's sign in. Okay. Now let's click on the 2FAS extension and let's click on the approve. And the token is sent. Bada bing, bada boom. Ready. That was easy, right? Now, remember that you can always unpair your phone from your browser, but naturally remember that it won't work anymore with this browser. On the other hand, you can always add another browser extension to your phone, and you can add another phone to the same browser extension. So you can have multiple phones paired to your browser, and you can have multiple browsers paired with your phone. And that's it! Now you know how to log in two times faster. As usual, if you like this video, leave a like and remember to subscribe to our channel. See you!